Good evening. You're watching Left, Right and Center. I'm Nidhi Razdan. Tonight, Indian industry raises the red flag over the government's move to impose a cess to help fund the Swachh Bharat initiative. Industry says it goes against the government's push to improve the ease of doing business. The 0.5% cess on all taxable services takes effect from Sunday. Is it a necessary step to fund an important scheme, or is it a nuisance that burdens taxpayers even more? We'll be coming to that in just a few minutes from now. But first, let's cross over to my colleague Sunetra Chaudhary, who joins us live from the Wembley Stadium in London this evening, where in a short while from now, Prime Minister Modi will be arriving for what is perhaps the highlight of his visit to the UK. It'll be an address to the British Indian community, and perhaps, Sunetra, 60 to 70,000 people are expected to be there tonight.
Nidhi, I can barely hear you, so just take a look over here. Let me just pan and show you exactly. The people have started arriving, and even though there's some time left before Prime Minister Modi comes, people have already, the warm-up acts have started playing, and that's what we'll keep live, and it's bound to be a major, major show. Vijay Chaudhawala, who is the organizer, if they is here, it was raining earlier, that must have really worried you.
Absolutely not. We were knowing that people are very enthusiastic. In fact, I myself, when I walked in the rains, on the metro.
Even if it rains, you expect people to
be here.
People
to wear. Absolutely no problem.
Yeah. And it's really loud now, but I spoke to some of the singers who are here, Jay Sean, and they're talking about some surprise. What is the surprise that people
Well, you will come to know at the end.
What kind of surprise? Give us some clue.
Miss, of course, there is a firework, but there is one additional surprise which you will come
to. Thanks very much. So, everyone over here, apart from the political speech, which is about 45 minutes long, that's towards the end of the show, what they're also saying is that right on top over there, over the pitch, which has the British and the Indian flag, they're going to have a major fireworks display. So, real show planned here at Wembley this evening, and we'll keep tracking that.
Now it's actually going to be, I think, after 9:30, 10 p.m. Indian time, when the Prime Minister will be there. Thanks a lot for joining us. Perhaps the biggest address that the PM will have while talking to the Indian community while traveling abroad. He started that tradition with Madison Square Garden in New York last year. Well, moving on to our big debate tonight about whether India needs a Swachh Bharat cess. As we mentioned, that cess is going to come into effect from this Sunday. That's the 15th of November. And some of the things that it could affect are the following. For instance, eating out could be a little more expensive now. So will air travel, phone bills. All of these are going to cost more because these already face a service charge. And it is on that this cess is now going to be applicable. The fee for banking services like fund transfers and credit cards will also go up. Processing and payment fees for home, auto and personal loans will also go up, as will insurance and equity schemes that attract a service tax. All of these are now going to cost more. Now, it's just 0.5%, and what the finance ministry says is that this will translate into a tax of 50 paisa only on every 100 rupees worth of taxable services. Now, many people believe it's worth it. Swachh Bharat is an important cause. It's a good cause and it needs more money, much more money. But on the other hand, there are many who believe this is just an additional burden on the taxpayer. Surjit Bhalla, well-known economist and author, joins us on the program tonight. We also have with us Raghav Chadda from the Aam Aadmi Party, Ajay Kumar, advisor with Sulabh International, and Sambit Patra of the BJP joining us this evening. Rahul Ishwaran, author and activist, joining us from Trivandrum. Dr. Surjit Bhalla, let me ask you first, just break it down for us. What actually, you know, becomes expensive? From what we've understood, there are quite a few services that now will become a little more expensive. You think it's a good idea in principle at all?
Not in principle, not otherwise either. And it doesn't fit in with the expectation of economic reform. What reforms mean is that it's a very straightforward taxation transaction on the part of the government. If you start, the government already spends about 30% of GDP. So therefore, in order to add an expenditure, there should be some discipline that they can cut some other expenditure. You know, this illusion, who can be against cleanliness, right? You are for cleanliness, I am for cleanliness, the Pope is for cleanliness. So therefore, who can be against climate change? or trying to battle climate change. We should have a cess for that also. And who can be against cleaning up the environment and look at the pollution in Delhi? Let's have a cess for that also. So everybody can dream up a cess for every, oh, we have to help the poor. Let's have a cess on that. So this idea that you just put on a cess for anything you want to do is really counter to any idea of economic reform.
So it's interesting when you look at the number of cesses that are, you know, one already is having to pay some bit. Among them, there is an education cess. I believe there's one on clean energy also. There's one on roads. And now you have one on exports, and now you have one on this. Sambit, as Dr. Surjit Bhalla says, this is unnecessary and this isn't the way to go about it. How would you respond?
No, with due respect to Surjit Bhalla ji, he's a well-known economic commentator and columnist. We all respect him. But I would say, I would beg to differ by saying that, as was pointed out by Nirmala Sitharaman, that when the nation is in a mission mode, it should not be seen as a burden. I mean, the cess should not be seen as a burden. And as you rightly pointed out, that there is an educational cess, there's a higher educational cess as well. As important as education is cleanliness. And it's not that if we are paying a 0.5% levy on the taxable services, it will be benefited for the people of this country at large. Because if you know, I mean, the health on the health cards, the amount that this government, that this country is spending is exorbitant, is huge. So if we are clean, if we maintain cleanliness of the nation, it's but natural that we are going to reduce on the, we are reducing on our health health budget as well. So it is absolutely a circle which has to be looked from that point of view.
But Sambit, you know, many would argue, let me take this to Raghav Chaddha. Raghav, many would argue that, you know, the Swachh Bharat campaign, for example, already has some more than 3,600 crores that were allotted to it in the union budget. The point is, I think people need to know what's happening with the money and how it's being used, the money that's already been allotted. And you know, okay, I think people might be willing to pay a cess, even this 50 paisa per 100 rupees, as long as they know the money is going somewhere and it's being used properly. Raghav.
Yes, Nidhi, two points. Point number one on the nature of the levy. Point number two on the purpose of the levy. Cess is considered to be a lazy government's tax. It was termed as bad tax by the Direct Tax Code 2009 as well as by the Economic Survey 2014 of this government. It is considered as a bad tax, as a regressive tax. And the maximum incidence of this tax is on the poorest sections of society. Look at what the government is doing. On one hand, they have reduced the direct taxes on corporates by bringing the rate down from 30% to 25%. On the other hand, they are increasing the indirect taxes on the public at large, first by increasing the service tax from 12% to 14% and now imposing a Swachh Bharat cess of 0.5%. Point number one. Point number two, or the purpose of the cess. If Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is considered to be an important campaign, pet project of the government of India, pet project of the Prime Minister, it ought to be given priority when it comes to first charge on the main budgetary resources of the government. Sanitation for all, education for all, basic road connectivity, etc. are the principal responsibilities of the government, which ought to be funded by the core budgetary resources of the government. Levying taxes on unrelated activities to fund a particular program, you know, particularly shows this government's misplaced public finance priorities as well as the confused tax regime. Now, if you juxtapose this with what the Aam Aadmi Party government did in Delhi, when we presented our first budget in the month of July this year, we did not increase value added tax on even a single commodity, perhaps for the first time in the history of India. And we displayed our commitment, our priorities by increasing the education budget by a whopping 100% and increasing the healthcare budget by a whopping 50%.
Let me take that back to Sambit.
Nidhi, just let me complete. Let me complete. We used revenue augmentation with the existing sources of inflow of the government.
So Sambit, the point that Raghav is making here is that if Swachh Bharat is such an important initiative, shouldn't it come from the budget and not from cesses and surcharges?
In fact, as far as the technical point is concerned, about the budgetary allocation for the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, there are four modalities through which the budget would be allocated. One is the budgetary allocation, what Raghav was talking about. The second is a cess It was 2%, mind you, when the initial budget was presented, but it is right now 0.5%, the notification that the government has come up with. The Swachh Bharat Kosh, the course that the fund allocation from the government, and fourthly by the corporate social responsibility. So all these four modalities would be funding the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Though I did not want to bring a mission mode to a political squabble that my friend from Aam Aadmi Party is trying to reduce it to right now, but let me also remind him of the fact that they have increased the VAT services on petrol and diesel from 20% to 25% in Delhi. So they cannot say that they have not reduced any kind of taxation in Delhi. As far as Swachh Bharat mode is concerned, Nidhi would agree to the fact that for the first time, mission cleanliness is discussed in this country in an unparalleled attitude. Let me also remind the Aam Aadmi Party that they have spent 536 crore rupees on their self-advertisement. Only 100 crore rupees has been spent on Swachh Bharat advertisements.
So the comparison cannot be made. I'll give you a chance to respond, but let me just get a view from somebody who's working on this whole Swachh Bharat thing on the ground, and that's Ajay Kumar, who's with Sulabh International, who can give us a perspective of whether this money is needed or not. You've seen the situation on the ground. Does it need an additional cess?
Nidhi, we welcome the introduction of 0.5% cess, because right now the position is that 12 crore toilet has to be constructed in India by 2019. So we require 360,000 crore rupee to construct in toilets and make India ODF.
360,000 crore.
So this 0.5% introduction of 0.5% says is just minuscule. We require to explore fund from different sources also, like the private donors, like the CSR fund, MPLAD program, MLA fund. Even we can requesting government to introduce the bank loan also.
Okay,
for the construction of the toilets. And you know, this has a very big implication on the health. Without toilet, you cannot have a good health in the family.
Because the estimates are, Surjit Bhalla, that this cess alone could raise about some 400 crores in the remaining fiscal. Now, you've heard Ajay Kumar of Sulabh International saying that if we want to build these many toilets by 2019, they need 360,000 crores. Now, that's a huge figure. So when you look at it that way, does the cess seem that unreasonable?
Well, look, it's chalk and cheese. First, you talk about, Nirmala Sitharaman said, we've got to be in a mission mode. Can you please tell me what is not in a mission mode on the part of the government? You want a clean environment. You want toilets to be built for all. You want equity to be delivered. You want food for all. You want disease to be get rid of. I mean, what kind of nonsense is this that we are in a mission mode? I grant you, absolutely correct. I also welcomed, along with everybody else, this whole mission of cleaning up the environment, of providing toilets for all. Nobody's against it. But why don't you cut your expenditures? Maybe buy a few less planes. That will do it. Why isn't that in mission mode? So the idea that, listen, I'll put on a cess for anything I dream about, then all taxation is for naught. Remember the same kind of argument was used when the finance minister Jaitley said we need MAT because that will give us 43,000 crores and that will provide irrigation for all. Listen, and what happened? The MAT was turned out to be a very, very black tax, a very, very bad tax, and the government had to withdraw. So the point is, I can make up arguments. Everybody can make up arguments. We're all intelligent people over here and we all want a clean India. But the idea is get that money from somewhere else. There has to be some check and balance on the government, some discipline on the government, rather than anything you dream about just because it's holy, you think that we can put on a cess. I am against the education cess. I am against this cess. I'm against all cesses. Increase the tax rate. Why don't you just increase the tax rate?
It's interesting, and Rahul Ishwar, let me bring you in on this, because you're supporting this cess as well. I think Dr. Surjit Bhalla will actually be able to elaborate on this better, about just how few people in this country pay taxes. And ultimately, when these cesses are imposed, it is the salaried class that is already paying a lot of taxes and genuinely declaring their income that ends up getting burdened more. And the guys who actually make the crores and crores every year, who don't declare their income, who don't have to pay the cess, who don't have to do anything. Rahul.
Any tax is unpleasant, but we all know no pain, no gain. And if I can borrow from your tagline, cess is a necessary nuisance. We all respect Surjit Ballaji, but you know, economic reform doesn't mean we abandon the idea of a welfare state. Even though it's out of vogue, we still believe in a socialist state because that's ingrained in our constitution. We know tax is not a pleasant thing, but we have to take care of our poor sections, our weaker section, and ease of doing business also means a more clean or a more hygiene, a more clean atmosphere. Even if you take the dengue cases, 3,500 plus crores we are spending for it. Cleanliness, more hygiene will decrease our burden on health expenditure. So we have to see any new tax on a holistic paradigm. Unless we see them on a holistic paradigm, we tend to cut and break this. On a holistic note, cleanliness is the most important thing, and we shouldn't trivialize the idea of a mission mode.